So here we start with the gross anatomy of the pulp space of the fingers. So in the gross anatomy of the pulp space of fingers, it is also known as the space of Whitlow. So therefore, they are the spaces which are present between the skin and the phalanx, that is distal phalanges of all the digits. The spaces which are present between the skin and the distal phalanges of all the digits, this is called the pulp space. In order to understand this pulp space, we are going to draw a line diagram, longitudinal section. So here, this is the longitudinal section of the distal phalanx. Head, the base. Similarly over here, we are going to show the middle phalanx. This is the middle phalanx, and only a half section we are going to show. Distal phalanx, middle phalanx, this is the distal interpharyngeal joint. Mainly we concentrate on the distal phalanx, and we divide the distal phalanx into the proximal part, this is 1/5, and the distal segment, which is 4/5. So the distal part of the distal phalanx, which is 4/5, this is the proximal part, 1/5. Simple. So this much will be the distal 4/5 of the distal phalanx, this much will be the proximal 1/5 of the distal phalanx. Now we are going to cover it with the skin, and we just show, this is a longitudinal section, remember, this is a longitudinal section, and we are going to show the dorsum. This is the dorsum of the skin, and we are going to show the nail portion. So this will suffice as the nail here. This is the fold of aponychium, and over here we are going to show, this will be again the fold of the skin, and this is the skin over here, palmar surface, dorsal surface. This is the nail, longitudinal section of a digit, entire longitudinal section of a digit, distal phalanx, the proximal part, the distal end of the middle phalanx, nail. This is the dorsum of the skin, tip of the finger. This is the cross section of the tip of the finger over here, and this is the palmar surface of the skin. Now here, what we show will be the space which is present between the palmar surface of the skin and the distal phalanx. This space is called the pulp space, which we are going to discuss. And in this pulp space, the entire skin of the palm is connected to the palmar surface of the distal phalanx by numerous fibrous septa, which are radiating in direction. So here we are going to connect with these fibrous septa. So here these are the numerous fibrous septa which are radiating, and they are connecting the palmar surface of the skin towards the distal phalanx. So each and every digit, will have the palmar surface of the skin, connected with the distal phalanx by numerous fibrous septa which are radiating in direction. And therefore, they will divide the entire pulp space into small, tight interseptal compartments. They will divide the entire pulp space of the finger into small, tight interseptal compartments because of this radiating fibrous septa. What is the pulp space? Once again, pulp space is nothing but the space which is present between the palmar skin and the distal phalanx. So this much space over the tips of the digits, all the digits, it is called pulp space. And these are the radiating fibrous septa. So therefore, these radiating fibrous septa will divide the entire pulp space into interseptal compartments. Each interseptal compartment will contain some amount of fats and digital vessels and nerves. So these are the interseptal compartments which will contain some amount of fat and digital nerves and vessels. Now here, if I mention this as fibrous septa and these spaces as interseptal spaces, and over here this entire is pulp space. Now blood supply. Now the blood supply will be in such a way that as these interseptal spaces, they contain digital nerves and vessels. So we show only one digital artery, and the digital artery, which is passing through the interseptal compartments of the pulse space, will supply blood to the distal 4/5 of the terminal phalanx, distal phalanx. In this distal phalanx, the distal 4/5 of the distal phalanx is supplied by the digital artery, which will pierce or will penetrate across these interseptal fibrous septa, across this fibrous septa, which is serving as interseptal compartments. So here we show that this is how the arterial supply, the artery, the digital artery will traverse, it will penetrate the fibrous septa, it will pass through by penetrating the fibrous septa through all the interseptal compartments and will supply blood supply to the distal 4/5 of the distal phalanx. What about proximal 1/5? The proximal 1/5 of the distal phalanx will receive a separate blood supply without the artery piercing any of the fibrous septa. So the blood supply from the digital artery towards the distal 1/5 will be a separate blood supply, which will not pierce any of these fibrous septa. So it will not pass through any of the interseptal compartments. The blood supply, the artery which supplies the proximal 1/5 of the distal phalanx. Now, this pulp space and the fibrous septa, they are, this entire pulp space and the fibrous septa, this much is the pulp space, will be distal to the attachment of fibrous flexure sheath, will be distal to the attachment of fibrous flexure sheath. For example, here you show the attachment of fibrous flexure sheath. This is where the fibrous flexure sheath is attached to the base of the distal phalanx. And just beneath the fibrous flexure sheath, you show the long flexor tendon. This is also attached over here. So therefore, distal to the long flexor tendon and fibrous flexure sheath is the pulp space with the fibrous septa. This is the gross anatomy of the pulp space, which we have discussed, and the digital artery, which supplies the distal 4/5 and proximal 1/5 of the distal phalanx. So here we are going to mention this as digital artery. Now, applied anatomy. Now, if we consider the applied anatomy, I will write down over here. Applied anatomy, the first point. Any infection of this pulp space of Whitlow, as it is called, the pulp space of Whitlow, any infection of the pulp space of Whitlow will have severe throbbing pain in this pulp space because of the increased tension in all these interseptal compartments. So therefore, infection of the pulp space will have severe throbbing pain on the tips of the digits or on the pulp because of increased tension in the interseptal compartments. Then number two, so here increased infection will have severe throbbing pain. I hope this is visible over here. Then number two, second point will be, there will be, in cases of this infection, if there is a surgical incision to be made, then the incision should always be on the lateral side of the pulp space. So any surgical incision to drain the pus or infected material from this pulp cavity, the incision should be on the lateral margin of the digit, terminal phalanx, so that all the interseptal compartment, the interseptal compartments are opened up without the damage to the sensitive area of the pulp. So incision should be on the lateral side of the terminal phalanx, lateral side of the digits, to open the or to drain the pus from the infected pulp space, in order to open all the interseptal compartments, and in order that the sensitive pulp of the finger should not be damaged. So that is point number two of applied anatomy, where surgical incision should be on the lateral side. And the third and the last applied anatomical point will be, sometimes in neglected cases of the infection of the pulp cavity, there will be avascular necrosis. Now remember, avascular necrosis, this is many times asked in MCQ. All these 3 points are many times asked in MCQ, but the last point, avascular necrosis, is a common question of the MCQ. Avascular necrosis will be affecting the distal 4/5 of the distal phalanx, whereas the proximal 1/5 of the distal phalanx will not have any avascular necrosis, since it is receiving independent blood supply. The blood supply in such a way that the artery which is giving blood to the proximal 1/5 will not pass through the pulp space of Whitlow. It is having a different blood supply. It will not penetrate this fibrous septa or enter the pulp space of Whitlow. That is why this proximal 1/5 of the distal phalanx will usually escape avascular necrosis, or it will not have any kind of avascular necrosis. So avascular necrosis will be there for the distal 4/5 of the distal phalanx, routinely asked MCQ. And why? That is because of this artery which is penetrating, the digital arteries which penetrate all the interseptal compartments, and then it supplies the distal 4/5 of the distal phalanx. So point number 3 is, in neglected cases where there is no surgical line of treatment or no medicinal line of treatment of infected pulp spaces, and if those cases are neglected, then what can happen? There may be avascular necrosis of the distal 4/5 of the distal phalanx, but the proximal 1/5 of the distal phalanx will not have any avascular necrosis. So these are the 3 points, 1, 2 and 3 of applied anatomy of the pulp space of Whitlow. And here we end our gross anatomy of the pulp space of Whitlow. Thank you very much.